You also spoke to the IGP the previous evening.
Yeah.
And told him
that there is information.
That the information that something might happen the next day. Right?
Yeah.
So how did you get that information to...
SIS, I was not well that day, I was sleeping. But although I had a very bad headache, my telephone was working. And then I got a call at about, I really don't know, maybe 6:30 or 7, I don't know, by Director SIS. He said, sir, I have sent a WhatsApp message, read it. That's what he said. Normally, I don't like WhatsApp. I hate WhatsApp. But I read it.
Why?
And then it was information about a possible attack. And then I spoke to Director SIS again. I said, what now? I read the message. What? So I have already spoken to IGP. I've given all the information. You please speak to IGP and put some pressure. I spoke to IGP. Then he confirmed that he is aware. He's making arrangement. And I said, if there's anything, you get back to me. Then I tried to contact Director SIS. His phone was engaged. Then I sent him a message. I spoke to IGP, come back.
Now, this is a very serious information that something was going to happen the next day. The president was not in the country. Didn't you think that you had to inform the president at that point?
Honorable sir, even at that point, I did not think that I should inform. The reason I will explain little later.
The reason is that you
they are very, very personal and...
No. Personal issues, you can tell, say it here. Only if it has any adverse impact on national security, we will hear it in camera. You can't choose what you want to say in public and what you want to say in private.
Okay, I will. Let me explain. The only thing that we can do is the pass the information on to the law enforcement agency in Sri Lanka, that is the Inspector General Police. So it has been done by the SIS, and I also spoke to IG. I said, what is the situation? He is, I'm making arrangements, so I'll get back if there's necessity, right? And Director SIS also confirmed, and they are working on that. Get back to me if it is necessary. But nobody spoke to me.
Question is, why didn't you think the President should be informed? Didn't you think that the President should be informed?
Yes, I think, sir. But I thought President has already been informed.
By the SIS chief.
Yes.
Because that was the practice.
Yes, that was the practice.
That was the practice. And you assumed that the President had been informed by the SIS chief.
Yes.
And therefore, you were not required to do. Is that what you are trying to say? Was there any information given to the President in your presence?
No.
No.